Hey, AOK product reviews. Meanwhile, here in Indiana, we have sunny and 85 degree weather all day. And for some reason, we've had a power outage here in the country for the past 4 or 5 hours. Don't get it. I don't understand that. No explanation. Nobody tells us why. Just deal with it. So it brings me to the topic of what would America do if a superior country attacked our grid? You know, my wife and I right now are a wreck. And I can't even keep my boxes on the table straight, let alone deal with the concept of not having power for a long period of time. Have y'all even thought about that? Or does that make you a conspiracy theorist? Does that make you a prepper? If you think about our grid being attacked, if you think about the possibility of power in America not existing, I mean, I feel privileged that I'm even able to shoot this video on my cell phone without power, because ultimately, without power, these phones will stop working within 12 to 24 hours. What do you do then? What do you do then? I mean, I have two candles in front of me, and you can see this part of my face, and then you see the light back there, and that's from the flashlight I just bought from Harbor Freight. Yeah, go figure. Harbor Freight came through again, surprisingly enough, even though I kind of trashed the whole brand just the other day. The only thing I liked was this magnifying glass with roach clips on it. Really? So, I felt like, why not shoot a video? I'm sitting here in the dark in Indiana. Why not shoot a video and discuss, what if? What do you do then? 24 hours goes by. Everybody's cell phones stop. People's food supplies, their candles come to an end. All medications. What happens? In my mind, in theory, America starts cannibalizing itself. The inner city does its thing, salvaging anything they can. A lot of crime and a lot of bad things will ensue. And then it'll work its way out into the country, where maybe a lot more of those people are better prepared to handle a grid down. And then they have to deal with what urban sprawl comes out into the rural areas. It's scary to think just how quick it can happen. The decivilization of our country, of the world, it doesn't need to be America, of the world can occur in just a matter of 72 hours. I don't know. I mean, I don't know. I worry about it. I think about it. You know, and I think about it without a 4-hour power outage. I mean, I don't even know what time it is, but they said the power would be back up. It went out 4:30. Here I'm shooting a video somewhere around 9, 10. I don't even know what time it is because I'm videoing on my phone, so I can't even really check. No, I can't check right now. But I'd rather shoot the video and discuss this, what I think is a hot topic. And I don't think it's conspiracy theory. I don't think it's a prepper's prerogative to you know. I love the ridicule. I don't love it. I hate it. But I love the ridicule you'll get from the urban left against the rural right. when we are about preparedness, when we are about the mistrust of our country and the mistrust of government. I wonder sometimes, why? How are they so naive? I invite, no, I don't invite because I don't want any of them on my property, but I invite them to just deal with a Friday night. Friday, because it happened in the day. I mean, Indiana, right about now, it doesn't get dark until 9 o'clock, and now it's dark. So I invite you guys to deal with no power, even for that period of time, without, I'm not saying it's tough. I find it peaceful. But I invite you to the tolerant left, the urban left, to try to enjoy this and not think about what if. You know, all you guys down in the big city, you're all on top of each other. You're right there. The danger is near. What do you do? Who do you reach for? You're all anti-gun. You're all anti so many things. You're anti-thought. You're anti-prediction. You're anti-what if. You're anti all the things that are anti-preparedness. You realize that, right? So hear me out. Is it bad to be prepared? Let's see. You're going to a sporting event. Let's say football, and you're not prepared, and you go to the football game without a helmet, without shoulder pads, without leg pads, without a cup, without cleats. Is that bad or is that good? Because in your school of thought, that's good to go to a football game without any pads, to not be prepared. When the crap hits the fan, what are you going to do? What do you have? You have no weapons. You have no stockade. You have no backup power. You have no backup food. You have no backup water resource. You have nothing. Even in the country, there's a lot of people that don't have that. I gotta be not honest. I'm just gonna tell you. I came home. My wife came home from work. Power went out and all that. And I live in the country, and I've got a level of preparedness out here, defensive-wise. But I learned that I have a well with endless amounts of water that I can't even get to because I have an electric pump. Yeah. So even the prepared country boys like myself, if we're not prepared even more, we'll suffer. I can't even flush my toilet twice. It's been 4 hours. I gotta poop. Yeah, you can't even poop twice. You can't even poop twice in a 4 hour time period without power in the country if all you have is an electric pump in your well. What's a city person going to do if they can't poop twice in 4 hours or can't poop twice in a day without being able to flush their toilet? You know what I mean? It's as simple as that. Let me introduce to you not being able to flush your toilet for half a day. It sounds gross, but it's real. It's real life. It's there. And so many people want to reject it, and they want to push it away, and they want to criticize, and they want to be skeptical of the people that are thinking about that, are concerned about that, and do know that that's a problem. We've got a big, big thing to worry about, guys, because China's patient. Russia's whatever. Our enemies are patient. But when they become impatient, an attack on our grid is going to be very easy for them. Really, it could be as simple as them paying some dumb-ass rednecks a significant amount of money to attack our grid. themselves. You know what I mean? It's that easy. China's got all the money in the world. Saudi Arabia's got all the money in the world. And there are some starving rednecks. There's some starving whatever city folk that would kill for $1 million and would do anything with an AK-47 and a block of C4. And they say, oh, what, just go to Duke Energy, set the block of C4 here? Okay, put the timer there? All right, sure. Shoot this battery cell? Okay, $1 million? I'll do it. That's what they're going to say. And that's all China has to do. And that's me talking about just like, say, people that are hungry. Let's talk about a meth head. Let's talk about a crackhead that really doesn't even want money. They just want a $10 rock. You don't think that guy's going to walk over to the Duke Energy and set a C4 block right where it takes down something that hits this and hits that? Next thing you know, that part of America's out of power. We got a lot of crackheads, and they got a lot of money. I'm not saying crackheads are our enemy, but I'm saying that they could be a tool. I'm saying anybody can be a tool. A hungry person can be a tool. So how about we stop criticizing and we stop thinking that conspiracies don't exist and that conspiracies are just, you know, whatever. Or that, not conspiracies, let's not even go there. Let's talk about just preparedness. People that are prepared are criticized and ridiculed. You know, if a guy has a cold cellar, you know, what do they call that? It's called something in the woods. It's called like a, I don't know. But, so he's got jarred food. They've got jarred food. They've got canned food. They've got whatever. They have water sources. They have backup power packs. They've got underground living circumstances, whatever. Those people are ridiculed and they're called crazy. What are they going to be called when it does happen? Geniuses? No, they're going to be called targets. That's how quick it goes. It goes straight from ridicule to target. There's no middle ground for those poor bastards. It's just straight up, you're either insane or you're food. That's it. Got real serious on this because I'm sitting here in this dark studio, room, office, whatever you want to call it, shop. And I'm thinking about these things. I'm thinking about how vulnerable we are every day. How quick the world will change and how quick attitudes will change if they have to suffer through a little bit of power loss. And you know who knows about that the most and who we should be talking to are people that were victims of Katrina, that were victims of hurricanes, tornadoes, and long, how about Puerto Rico? How long they went without power after these hurricanes. And there was suffrage, there was rape, there was crime, there was theft, there was just a serious dispatch of inhumanity that occurred. And we didn't focus on it in that way. We didn't say, hey, these people know. Let's talk to them. Because those people, they were leftist, they were rightist, they were Republicans, they were Democrats, they were liberals, they were conservatives, they were all sorts of everything, and they all suffered together. Did we learn anything from that? I don't think we did, because I can't recall a documentary that took a creative focus on the suffering of these folks and channeled it as a, okay, this was a hurricane, but what if it's an attack? Okay, this was a hurricane, but what if this is a purposeful attack on our community, on our society, on our country? It's real easy, guys. It's got to be easy. I mean, I'm like a MacGyver redneck, and I'm not even a redneck. I'm just a country boy, right? But I'm a MacGyver country boy, and I know just me sitting in my garage in my shop, I could put together something that could be bad. And that's me being a good person thinking badly. Like, because you have to do that. The what-if-isms are smart, good people thinking like bad people and saying, hey, I know these people can do this if they were organized. I know this could happen if there was an organization or a country or a government that decided to attack another government, country, or organization, that it wouldn't be that hard. I almost don't understand why it hasn't happened, to be honest with you. But this goes into my deeper. There's the power. How about that? Oh, it's okay. Let's talk about knives. That's what happens. Look at that. Here. Look. Now I got lights on my... Okay. I'm not worried about it anymore. Life's good. America's great. What was that guy talking about? What was that guy even talking about? Why would he even talk like that? That's so severe. That was so extreme. Why would that guy even talk that way? That's terrible. We've got power. Look, my refrigerator's working. My cocktails are going to be cold now. I can flush my toilet. What is he even talking about? That's what happens, people. You saw it live right here. I mean, like, boom, magic. Everything came back on. And this isn't staged, guys. This really happened. I just had a... I was just in a power outage for 5-6 hours. And I was upset and concerned and worried. But you see how quick, like, you can just say, hey, what were you worried about? There's nothing to be worried about. You know? Okay, so now let's talk about knives. Let's talk about knives. I did 3 knives this week. This video is going to be longer now because now I can talk about knives because I have a positive attitude because the world's good and everything's fine. There's nothing to be worried about. We're safe. Okay. First knife I reviewed this week was the Case Kinzua. This knife's been growing on me all week. It only took a week. When I first held it and saw it, I was not impressed. I don't know why, because it's an impressive knife. This upper detent, or whatever that's called. Okay, now I'm going to be critical. So that keeps it from a drop from up here. It's going to hit that. It's not going any further, right? See the angle of this scale? Why wouldn't you put that right there? Tell me, Case. Tell me, knife people. Why is this angle that's off kilter and off kilter of the scale and not creating perfect symmetry, why would that be any different if it was right there? Now you have perfect symmetry, perfect angle with your scale. I feel it's a design flaw. I need somebody to tell me why it's not a design flaw. Maybe they could have changed the scale to be that angle, or maybe they could have changed the detent to be that angle. If that angle is important, I don't know. I'm going to be critical tonight. I'm not going to be funny, if you even thought I was funny in the first place. I'm just going to be critical. My critique on the Case starts there and probably stops there. Why do you even have this like that and not just have a full drop? Tell me why. Safety. Okay. Now, why does it have to be that angle and not an angle that matches the scale angle? See what I mean? Watch. Let's do this, a close-up of this. That's matching. That is not matching, and that's where it does the lockup or the detent thing. Okay, so there's that. Love the anodized scales. I just like them. Sometimes I like them. Sometimes I prefer something grippy. On a knife like this, it's what I would want. Let me give you a good example of what I think an anodized scale, a stainless steel scale, a titanium scale is good for when it's nice and smooth like this. and then a nice stone wash on the blade. A mechanic. Somebody who gets their hands greasy. Somebody who gets their hands dirty and grimy. This is super wipeable. There's no nooks and crannies in the surface of the scales. There's nothing there to catch or create any kind of funk later on in the life of the knife. It's super wipeable. I feel these are great work knives. I got a good buddy. His name's Tom Bradshaw, and he's a mechanic. And I gave him a knife. He gave me a knife. A great one, Tactical Gears with G10 scales. I gave him a knife back that was cheaper, maybe better than what he gave me, though, because it had stainless steel. It was a Steinbrock or Steinbrick. It was one of those 10 onion leak knockoffs. $12 for 14C28N steel. Stainless steel scales, all that. It's 12 bucks. And it was assisted open. Some people don't like that. Whatever. My point is, though, he was like, you could tell as soon as I gave it to him, he was like, yeah, I'll take that. Because you know he was thinking, that's what I need. My hands are always grimy. Imagine that on this beautiful micarta, and you stick a greasy palm on that sucker. That would be like sacrilege. Same thing on this. This G10 with this really nice, grippy G10. It would be better than a micarta because it won't stain, but you'll have that grime, that funk, and you don't have the grip anymore. Now you just got grease and gunk in there. Yeah, not on this. Okay, I really like the Case Kinzua, and it grows on me every day. Next knife. Second knife on the thing. Because what I'm going to do here is I'm going to talk about these. I'm going to be critical. I'm going to do whatever. But I'm going to tell you right now, these three knives, I'm going to have to come up with a favorite, and it's going to be so difficult because these are three of the most different knives at this level that I've ever dealt with. Yeah, before I'm dealing with a Kaiser Assassin, a Petrified Fish Flavorist, and a something else. And they're all very similar. So it was easy. I was like, okay, it's this. These, so different. Same price range. Same metals. Steel. This cold steel is really, really just like cold steel, like you'd expect if you know anything about cold steel. I mean, let's wipe it down real quick because it's got some smudges on it. You're not going to have that on your stonewash, really. Yeah, but let's make it pretty for you so you can see it. This thing, cold steel must have hired somebody who has just, I think like a Viking. I think they have a Viking in their engineering department or in their factory, a Viking, because their knives are Viking knives. Their knives are brutal. They embody strength. They embody force. They think about stuff. And they put it to action. I like this clip point too. And I'm not a huge clip point guy. Love the grip. Love everything. Love the angles. Love the feel. If I was a true warrior, like I used to be, I would eliminate this pocket clip and just go no pocket clip. Maybe lanyard it out. Because there is a you can feel it there. And I would sheath it. I think I'm going to look into, I think they make an AK-47 fixed blade. Art. Hardcore art. Purposeful art. Now, we're going to get to the Benchmade proper. Proper art. Yeah. Look at this bad boy. This knife is... My grandpa died, the West Virginia sportsman, Tom Hawkins. He died 1984. And if I could do one thing, I would love to have him alive so I could give him this knife. That's how strong I feel about it. Benchmade This is, I think I feared this about Benchmade. I feared the addiction. You know, it's kind of like, you hear people talking about cocaine, you hear people talking about crack, you hear people talking about methamphetamines, you hear people talking about fentanyl. This is a knife lover's cocaine. Yeah. And I mean that in the best way. God, that just went so raw. And Benjamin's probably going, they just compared our knife to cocaine? Yeah, I did. And I don't care. Could you imagine this with a clip? What a disservice that would have been. Look at that. Imagine a clip on this knife. The knife designers, the big boys that are right there, they're like the sun to knife people who are designing these and making these, and they're at Benchmade and they're at Cold Steel and they're at Case and they're at all these great manufacturers of knives. There's a guy at some point that said, hey, why don't we put a clip on that knife? It'll fit in my pocket and hold it still. It should have a clip. You know there was probably somebody at Benchmade that said, if you don't get that guy out of this room, I'm going to kill him with my Benchmade knife. I'm going to kill him. I'm going to cut his throat. I guarantee you there's a passionate engineer in that room. And he's probably a Viking, just like the Cold Steel guy. And he said, if you don't get that freaking nerd out of our engineering room, I'm gonna slice his artery. Because this knife should never have a clip. As simple as that, a clip. Look, I'm taking this Cold Steel clip that almost matches the angle, because you gotta have an opposing angle clip for this to have a lefty carry. And it almost fits this knife. Yeah. Look at that. Almost fits this knife right. And I could probably fire a couple screws in there, and some people would say, wow, this is great. It's got a clip. No one understand. Some things just aren't supposed to be. Some things just aren't supposed to have certain things. This knife. Yeah, I wish my grandpa could hold this knife. Something tells me he would be proud of his grandson for handing him a Benchmade slip joint proper. Right now, out of all my knives, I believe this is the knife that I would give my grandpa if he was still alive. And if not that, it would be the Case. If not the Case, it'd be the Cold Steel. Yeah, you know, I covered all three. No, seriously though, it would be this. I have to throw a joke in there or some humor or something just to break it a little. But yeah, I'll keep this for a while. But that points me in a direction about keep. I'm not going to keep my collection. I've decided today, sold 100% today, that my 2023 collection of knives that I purchase and review on the channel, that are purchased and reviewed sheerly for product review, not my, you know, my Colt boot knife that Billy Screws gave me. Nobody's getting this. This is gonna die with me. Actually, I told my wife, put it in the box they burned me in. Yeah. This one and a couple others. You're gonna see one of them next week. My cousin who passed away made me a Damascus custom fixed blade knife. And then one of my best friends, Brad Garland Gear, made me a sheath. And wait till you see this. You'll see, if you look at my earlier videos, I did a review on that knife that my cousin Bob Ralph made for me. But now I've got a custom sheath made by one of my best buds. That'll never go anywhere. No. But everything else, this knife, Cold Steel AK-47, this will be in somebody's collection that subscribes to me, that I appreciate and they appreciate me. This case, this one, definitely, it's gonna be hard to part. But what I've declared is if you know me and you know my channel, I keep a knife roll. I keep two knife rolls. Dos. Knife rolls. Dos knife roll. I don't know what language that was, but it was something like that. Dos knife roll. Yeah, one of those. Let's have another drink. Dos knife rolls. One holds 36 knives, the other holds 8. And then I still have knives everywhere. Knives over there, knives here, knives there, knives here. I will take away, like I said, the important knives that aren't part of this. And I will take away the top eight that I have. These top eight will carry on from 2023 to 2024. It may not be these same knives because they're going to get replaced by others. You know, I've got the Milwaukee Fastback in there. But I'll tell you right now, once I get my lanyard and custom bead from Curiosity Forge, that knife will be in there and go to 2024 most likely. Yeah, because I just basically said that if my grandpa was alive, I'd give it to him. How could I just give that away this year? Maybe next year. So maybe I will always buy another one. Just decided I'm giving it away this year. That's how committed I am to my channel and to my subscribers. Do you hear my tone? Look at me. Look me in the eye. See my finger pointing at you. Somebody's getting this bench made. And you know I love this knife. And I'm not pissing around. Yeah. You know this is my favorite, guys. I don't know what to do. I don't think I can do a favorite on this three. I don't think I can do it. I am mad at the Cold Steel because it cut me open already. There and on my thumb. I got to be clear. S 30 something. 30 or 35 V CPM steel. So business. Don't mess with it. So sharp. The real dangerous thing is this AK-47 triad lock right here. This bottom detent is like a guillotine. Guillotine. That's what did that. Whack. Right into my flesh. Straight to my bone. Didn't go to the bone, but it sounded good. All right. So let me get back on track. Put the Milwaukee back in here. I'm going to tell you right now. I'm going to end 2023 with this knife roll. With 8 of my favorite knives at the end of the year. And before that happens, I will purge my whole inventory of knives. My whole inventory of purchased and bought knives for product review in 2023. And they will all be given to my subscribers. And I'm starting soon. I'm doing 7 giveaways right now. 7 giveaways. And they're 3 knives per giveaway. So if you win, you're getting 3 knives from my collection. No, they're not great. They're all lower budget knives right now. Because that's how I'm going to purge bottom up. We're going to get this started from the bottom and go to the top. But I'm going to tell you right now, though. Somebody's getting this bench made proper before 2023 is over. Yeah, somebody's getting this Case Kinzua. Everybody loves Case. And everybody loves Cold Steel. Somebody's getting the Cold Steel AK-47. Yeah, I will not have this knife next year, and it will be in the hands of hopefully a proud and happy A-OK Ace dude. Yeah, Ace dude, that didn't sound right. Hey, oh, for fuck's sake, it's the only time I'm really going to say the F word. I've maybe said the F word on my channel out of about 400 videos, maybe 3-4 times tops. Yeah, one of my best friends. And I'm going to call her one of my best friends, Becky. And it's one of my best friend's wife, fiance, Becky. That ass Becky, Long Island, and Billy Screws. They're a couple. They live here in Indiana now. She brought me this pen today because that's one of her sayings, for fuck's sake. That's great. She's a Long Island girl. She's just rotten to the core, but I love her. She's not really rotten to the core either. She's a sweetheart. Don't tell her I said that, though, because I'm never nice to her. Never be nice. Never be nice to your friends. Be respectful. Be courteous. But never be nice. Never show them weakness. Never show them the soft side of you, because they will eat you alive, even your friends. Be tough on your friends. If you're not tough on your friends, who can you be tough on? All right. I'm going to stop there. I'm going to tell you right now, I'm very, very pleased with this knife. I think it's so everything. I'm very pleased with this knife. I did have a problem with that angle there, and that's it. And this really strong, you hear that? You put that down by the mic. Yeah, I don't love that. And I'd be more okay with it if the angle matched the scale. That's just OCD crap, though. Okay, this thing is evil. It's drawn my blood twice already, and all I've done is reveal it. That means it's great. AK-47. I'm whistling the microphone. And the microphone's not even on because the power was out whenever I started this. I should be whistling down underneath my cell phone, but hey. Okay. So, if I was to put these in any kind of order, I wouldn't do it. But I did let you guys know, my subscribers, stick around. Tell your friends, tell other people, like, subscribe, comment, do all that crap. But tell them that Rich is giving away his whole 2023 collection before the end of the year. I'm doing it. I will not have. I will not see. I will not look. I will not tolerate any. And I'm not just saying knives. This is just this week's content for next week that I was going to try to do this week, but I just couldn't fit it all in. These are, look at all these. These are credit card multi-tools. More credit card multi-tools. More credit card multi-tools. Look at that credit card multi-tool. It doesn't look like it'll fit in your wallet, but there's something in there will, plus other stuff. And that was only 10 bucks. Yeah. And now we got cigar lighter kits and cutters, multi-tools, cigar kit. And we're talking Cohiba, guys. Not the junk. Everybody's heard of Cohiba. Promise. Guys, just a little glance. That's next week. Dropping stuff everywhere. I don't care. I mean, it's crazy. Victorinox credit cards. Look at all this stuff. I don't even smoke cigars. I've got so much money in these things for you guys. Not me, because I don't smoke cigars. What's in here? Ronx. R-O-N-X-S. Just a quick glance. These things are... I'm going to pull this one out. You deserve to see a little preview. Look at the beefy stock. It's black chrome. Stick your finger in there. Okay. Ooh. Could you imagine? I'm not even going to talk about where else that would be terrible. Yeah. Guys. These things. There's no... Look at that. That was cool. There's... So, it pops the lid. And then you light it. Yeah, that was a little sound effect, weird face looking thing there. Guys, this is going to be a good one. And I don't even, I'm going to have Brad in here because he's a big cigar guy. Victorinox credit card, multi-tool. I mean, it's just, Lord, what else? God, this video is going on 40 minutes. I got to carve off at least 20 minutes. I don't think I can do that because I love this one. Because some stuff happened. You saw real life apocalypse stuff. And then it turned into knife stuff. Then it turned into scar stuff. This is like, you can't stage this. You can't script this. You can't even, I don't think people can even make this shit up. I gotta go. Keep in mind, I'm doing giveaways the rest of the year. And it's just gonna be a landslide of giveaways. Everything I buy is going away. Yeah, everything. These things are really cool, guys. This knife on here, it might cut paper. But I'm not gonna do that right now because I gotta go. Good talking to you Friday night. Great apocalypse talk. Listen to what I say. Think about it. So start stocking up on some, you know, some water and shit. You never know. You're gonna get thirsty when the world comes to an end, I tell you that. Deuces. I gotta think of a catchphrase. Don't let your monkey drive the car. I think we got a winner. People want to dap it up, but they can't get none from it. I went to jail and snap it up, at least I had bum money. People want to rock around me, trying to steal my lingo. Just make sure when you talk about me, you say you're doing this thing, though. Ha, ha, yeah.